Today, I am going to present a topic on what is metabolic engineering with an example. Let me see about the introduction. Medicinal plants produce large number of chemicals, components or metabolites. Generally, it is called a secondary metabolite, which have the property of healing or having some functional properties. So what is a major drawback is it will produce in very less quantity. So when the demand is huge, it will become a problem. And next one is the isolation or extraction of specific component is very cumbersome. Since the quantity is very less, it becomes an uneconomical process also. Scientists have looked for alternative option to meet the demand of the particular component. So they have gone for the microorganism. So they have selected the prokaryotes and the eukaryotes, and they have gone for the synthesis of the synthesis of this new molecules. So olden techniques used for selection of the particular microorganism is screening and mutation technique. But this seems to be a random process. Hence, metabolic engineering is evolved. So what is the metabolic engineering? The metabolic engineering is directed improvement of product formation or cellular properties through the modification of specific biochemical reactions or the introduction of new ones with the use of recombinant technology. So these three things, first one is your product formation, second one is your altering the pathways to produce the particular product. Third one is the introduction of new genes for the production of the particular enzymes. So these three steps combine together to form your metabolic engineering. So now we'll see about the metabolic pathway manipulations. So if you take the examples for it, it consists of large number of molecules. So it is categorized into five groups by Cameron and Tong in 1993. The classification is as follows. First classification is yield and productivity improvement of products made by microorganisms. Second one is expansion of the range of substances that can be metabolized by an organism. Third one is the formation of new and novel products. Fourth one is your general improvement of cellular properties. And fifth one is your xenobiotic degradation. Now we will see an example for your metabolic pathway manipulations. So here I am going to explain about the tryptophan synthesis. So what this is the pathway for the production of tryptophan synthesis. Erythrospore phosphate and phosphoenol pyruvate combines together to form 3-deoxy-D-arabinoheptulosonate 7 phosphate, that is DAHP molecule, and it is converted into chorismate. And finally, it is deviated into three different pathways for the production of your tryptophan, phenylalanine and tyrosine. So three different genes are activated and it producing three different molecules. So the same substrate is responsible for producing three different components. So your product accumulation, the percentage of product accumulation will be getting varied by the environment and by the environmental conditions. So what we have to do is, if we want to produce the tryptophan, we want to block the other two pathways. So that is the one way to achieve it. And the second one is, this tryptophan is feedback inhibited by the molecule. So that molecule, inactivation of the particular gene has to be done to increase the synthesis of this tryptophan molecule. These two modification has to be done. So in the E. coli strain, they have gone for this modification and they have achieved to produce about 6.2 gram per liter of tryptophan by the modifications. And what are all the other strain modification so far done is, they have gone for this Cornibacterium glutamicum strain. It has the capability of to produce 18 gram per liter. That has been altered to produce large amount of tyrosine of 26 gram per liter. So this they have achieved by the overexpression of the deregulated DAHP synthase enzyme and carismate mutase enzyme. And further, they have additionally gone for this overexpression of the prephenate dehydratase enzyme, and this leads to the production of phenylalanine of 28 gram per liter. So these modification in the particular strain helps to improve the product accumulation in the cell. So by altering the metabolic pathways to produce the product and or either introducing a new gene to the system to alter the particular pathway, so thereby we are achieving the product, more product formation. So this is about metabolic engineering. Thank you.